Hello everyone and welcome to Knowledge Revolution 2.0. This is a new video related to government schemes. So before understanding what are the new schemes that the government have come up, we will first understand what is the difference between government schemes, policy and programs. Now policy is a set of rules. They are the guiding rules and regulations that are formed by the government but that are applicable for both the private and the public enterprises. So the private and the public enterprises both have to follow those rules, and these rules are made so that a policy, an economy should move in the positive direction. But sometimes the effects, the after effects of after implementing such policies, there can be some negative effects as well. So what are the types of policy that government comes up? Like industrial policy, like labor policy. Now labor, what are the after effects or what are the negative effects that can happen due to these policies implementation? Consider a labor policy where there are strict labor laws that a government should that a private entity should pay a minimum subsistence wage to a worker. Due to these strict labor laws, private enterprises are not able to hire more of labor because they do not want to pay more of the wages, and this can hamper the economic growth. So while they are protecting the rights of the workers, they are also hampering the entrepreneurs who are employing these workers. So this way it can go negative also. Now schemes are made for the benefits of the poor. So that not even poor, but yes, to all the public, it only provides benefit to the public. So if there is a scheme like Ujjwala scheme where you are giving incentives for providing, not incentive, but subsidy for getting installed the LPG, or there are other schemes as well. There was one scheme where the person has to declare his income to who are not paying proper taxes. So these are the schemes where a person gets benefit, and this the effects of these schemes can never be negative. So this is the difference between policy and scheme. Now coming to the program. Now, program is like a part of scheme. It is a very specific goal-oriented policy, or you can say the set of benefits that are provided to a specific group. So these programs are very specific, that if they want to achieve a specific goal of, say, reducing IMR, infant mortality rate, then that program will only be focusing on reducing the IMR and nothing else. So you can say that these programs are sub parts of the scheme. They also provide benefits, but they have a very specific goal and they are only focusing on achieving those goals. So this is what is program is. It is temporary improvement. So it is only temporary improvement that they are focusing on few things, and moreover, the timeline is also decided for the programs that we will only implement from this year to this year, and we will see the effects of that program. So this is how these programs work. Coming to the central sector schemes. Now you must have heard about these terms, central sector scheme and centrally sponsored scheme. So now I would like to clarify your doubts regarding them. The central sector scheme is a responsibility of the central government. Just pay attention to the names here. Both can be abbreviated as CSS, but here the names are different. One is central sector scheme, which is a responsibility of the central government. It means the 100% funding comes from the central government. And implementation is also a responsibility of the central government. Whereas the centrally sponsored scheme have a shared responsibility with the state government. So the central sponsored scheme are mainly formulated on the subjects that are in the union list. So if you if you have heard of the constitution, so there are three lists. One is the union, one is the state, and one is the concurrent, where both the state and the central government, they share the responsibility. So that comes under centrally sponsored scheme, whereas this union list is under the union list program. Topics are covered by the central sector scheme. So there are various programs that come under central ministries and that are implemented by the central ministries only. So those all are considered as central sector schemes. Now coming to the schemes or the programs that central ministries implement directly in states and UTs are also considered as central sector schemes. It does not mean that a central sector scheme has to be implemented on a national level only. They can be implemented by a particular ministry in a particular state also. So that is also considered central sector schemes. It means that all the funding will be provided by the central government to the state government for implementing that particular program. So it depends which program is considered in which list, or the classification of the program or the scheme is very important regarding the funding of the scheme. So these classification are only based on the funding provided either by the central or when it is shared by the central and the state government. Now coming to the centrally sponsored scheme, as I told you that the responsibility is shared by the center and the state, and why it is started so that states should also be made financially independent. So this was the reason for starting the centrally sponsored scheme. Regarding the funding of the centrally sponsored scheme, the state, they contribute a percentage of the funds. So neither it is the 100% responsibility of the center, nor it is the of the state. So they contribute in terms of the percentage. Implementation is generally made by the states or the UTs where that scheme has to be implemented, whereas in the central sector scheme, the implementation lies with the central government. Now here the implementation has to be lied with the state government. It means the administration, whatever the strict decisions that they have to take, whatever the way they are going to implement it, it is totally dependent on the state government. Now as you can see that the schemes are created on areas, these centrally sponsored schemes are created on areas that are covered under the state list. So here you can see that it is under the state list which are covered under centrally sponsored schemes. Now let's come to the number of centrally sponsored schemes that are right now working in India. So these figures are taken from the budget 2018-19, which is the recent budget that was launched. So the panel also grouped these schemes under three heads. There was a chief minister's panel that recommended that there should be reduction in the centrally sponsored scheme so that the burden that is there on the central government should be reduced and states should be made more financially independent. They should be responsible for their own schemes and they should be able to generate the amount for implementing such schemes. Therefore, they recommended that the number of schemes, centrally sponsored schemes, should be reduced. And the panel also differentiated, classified under three heads: core of the core, and optional. So this is regarding the importance, the strategic importance of the schemes, the way they are classified. So this restructuring, the classification came into being in 2016-17, and now the CCS are 28. So out of these, core of the core was 6, core schemes were 22. So now these two even are subgroups have been combined, and core and optional, whereas the core of the core is 6 and these two are combined here, 22. So as per the budget 2018-19, I am telling you this. Now coming to the types of these schemes. This Pradhan Mantri Awas Yojana, there are certain benefits that are provided to the people of housing facility. So under this scheme, there are various sub-schemes that are categorized under centrally sponsored and central sector scheme. So what is this? This is the housing facility that has to be provided in the urban areas, and it is implemented by the Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs during 2015-2022. And as I told you, these are specific ones and there is a timeline decided by the government for this. So under this, they will be providing central assistance to the urban local bodies and other implementing agencies through states and union territories. So the government will share, the central and the state government will share the responsibility, and they will provide assistance, they will provide funding to the urban local bodies, and which they will be providing funding to them, and they will be implementing this scheme in the urban area. So this is a scheme. Under this we have different sub schemes. First is in rehabilitation of existing slum dwellers. So this is a part of CSS, that is centrally sponsored scheme. Here you can see credit linked subsidies. So the person who is taking credit for building his own house, government is providing subsidy to them. So that comes under central sector scheme. Affordable housing in partnership. If a government is making flats in partnership with any private enterprise and then they are sold to the urban poor at very subsistent, at a very minimal amount, then that is known as affordable housing in partnership, and that is also a part of centrally sponsored scheme. Subsidy for beneficiary led individual house construction enhancement. So this is also CSS. So now you can see these are the types of centrally sponsored scheme. Now what was the things that were decided in 2018-19 budget regarding this Pradhan Mantri Awas Yojana, and this is the urban scheme that I'm talking about. There is a similar Grameen Yojana, Pradhan Mantri Awas Yojana Grameen, which is for the rural area, which is providing subsidy to the people for housing facility in rural areas. Now under this 2018-19 budget, the government will create a dedicated affordable housing fund. This will be providing amount for the Pradhan Mantri Awas Yojana, or you can say the housing for all. This is the motto of the government, that everyone should be provided with the housing facility, and this will be funded by this affordable housing fund in National Housing Bank. And government has planned that by the end of 2002, everyone will own their own houses. So this is what I was telling, that there is the motto of this housing for all. Now for this, there are more than 1 crore houses that are being constructed in the rural areas in the current and the next financial year under the Pradhan Mantri Awas Yojana. As I told you, there is a rural area scheme which has written Grameen in front of Awas Yojana. Now coming to the Pradhan Mantri Kaushal Vikas Yojana. Here I will again be describing what are the types of centrally sponsored and central sector scheme. This is the reason that I have taken such diverse schemes to explain you the difference between centrally sponsored and central sector scheme. Now this Pradhan Mantri Kaushal Vikas Yojana is for providing skill development to the
people who are looking for jobs, or youth you can say. So this has been approved for another 4 years, that is for 2016 to 2020. Earlier it was only till 2016, now it has been extended till 2020. Now to under this, they want to cover 10 million youth. They will be providing the skill development, and it is implemented by the Ministry of Skill Development and Entrepreneurship. They will be providing the certificates for completion of such a skill or training, that is vocational trainings or industrial training that they will be provided. So they will be provided particular certificates for completing this training, skill training and industrial relevant skill training. Under this scheme, training and assessment fees are completely paid by the government. So government takes all the burden of paying for these kids or youth. Now, this skill development program has come up with two new schemes. That one is Sankalp, the other one is Strive. Now, Sankalp and Strive both are different kinds of programs. One is centrally sponsored scheme. The Sankalp is a centrally sponsored scheme where they're getting support from World Bank as well. The center and the state both will contribute to the funding of Sankalp. Whereas Strive is a central sector scheme with half of the amount outlay as World Bank loan. So government has taken loan from World Bank for the outlay of Strive, whereas World Bank will be providing 3,300 for Sankalp, and for Strive they will be providing around 1,100 crore rupees to sponsor this Strive. And both will focus on improving the quality and the market relevance skill development training programs, which are for the vocational training. So this is all for today. We have discussed the types of centrally sponsored and central sector schemes to clarify you what is the difference between them. We also discussed the difference between policy scheme and program, and how the centrally sponsored scheme is different from central sector schemes. I hope this topic is clear to you. We'll be providing more videos on this topic. So if you have any query, let me know in the comment section and keep watching. Thanks.